3 months into the Korean War, the Army asked for volunteers to form 4 new Ranger infantry companies, including an all-African-American unit. More than 500 men applied. One of them was a young man from Oakland, California, named Cleveland Valrey. Here to tell Sergeant Valrey's story is distinguished actor Joe Morton.
All it took for me was to see the sign in the recruiting office in downtown Oakland. Join the Army, see the world. There was no question. I wanted to be a Ranger and a parachutist. About 120 of us made the grade. We were the first and only all-black Ranger company, a black elite force led by black officers. The Army sent us to jump school in Fort Benning, Georgia for training. Our brother company, the 4th Rangers, was all white. We became good friends. We practiced small-scale raids behind the lines near enemy headquarters. Get in fast, do your thing, get out. All of us knew it was going to be a long haul, but we were gung-ho, young, and invincible. We thought we could do just about anything. My first memory of Korea is the cold. We arrived in the dead of winter. The wind and snow never stopped blowing. We rode in open bed trucks with no canvas when it was 20 below. The pain was excruciating. The 2nd Rangers saw combat 7 days after we landed. We took small arms fire and grenades. Then they attacked in full force. Thousands of Chinese soldiers. If you got one, another would come. If you got 100, another 100 were right behind them. It was terrifying. Lost our first Ranger that night, Sergeant First Class Isaac Baker. That was a shock. No matter how much you think you're prepared, that first man killed changes the way you look at things. By the end of the first month, we were down to about 60 men and 1 officer. If a bullet didn't get you, the frostbite would. Take off your boots, all your toes would be frozen. Sometimes the only way you could follow a trail was by the bloody footprints of the man walking ahead of you. I was next to my partner, James Oakley, when the ice cracked right under him. I reached out my hand and tried to grab him. He had too much weight on his back. All that heavy ammunition pulled him right under. The current just took him away. You don't dwell on it right then. You know he's gone and not coming back. But later you think, why did he get killed and I didn't? Why him? Why not me? There was this one time I was leading the squad across a frozen river. We were taking fire from right in front of us on either side. I heard the word retreat. About 6 guys had already crossed the river, and most of my squad that turned to go back got hit. 3 days later, we went back to retrieve the bodies. Found them, stripped and frozen solid. Every one of them had been machine gunned, but there was no blood because it was so cold. You don't forget something like that. Not ever. War is hell. It just is. There's nothing pretty about it. In March of 51, they attached the 2nd Rangers to the 187th Airborne Regimental Combat Team as part of Operation Tomahawk. It was Good Friday. Our commander said to us, "Men, we're gonna make history." And we did. That was the first time in the U.S. Army that a black unit was included in an airborne combat jump. Every 2nd Ranger wanted to be part of it. A few guys even got themselves discharged from the hospital early just so they wouldn't miss the chance. We all knew it was dangerous. Guys did different things before the mission. Some wrote letters. I read my Bible. It wasn't the jump that bothered me. It was what might happen next. People say you can't see tracer bullets coming toward you. Don't believe it. I was glad to hit the ground in one piece. But I landed right next to a Chinese soldier. Didn't even see him until after a brother Ranger shot him dead and saved my life. I dove for cover. A white soldier dug in right next to me, and we heard the artillery whistling overhead. We both hugged the ground a little bit harder. There's no discrimination in a foxhole. The Second Rangers took our objective that day. We proved to ourselves and the rest of the Army that we were good as anybody. In Korea, it didn't matter what you believed or what color your skin was. We were all Americans, one nation under God. That's the country the Second Rangers fought for. On Memorial Day, I remember all the men I knew who we lost. I also think of the North Korean and Chinese soldiers we found dead. Sometimes they had photos of their families pinned inside their uniforms. That moved me deeply. I've heard Korea called the Forgotten War, but none of us who fought and suffered over there will ever forget it. We did our country proud, and we remember.